Hello and welcome to the Daily Vision Bible. I'm Robbie Yates. You know, I found myself helping out a small group of my church family today. We had been requested to fell a couple of trees, and I went along to see if I could offer any help. As you may guess, I am not used to manual labour, and I found myself shredding the branches from the trees. I told them that the only thing I had planned for today was recording today's reading, and they turned around and said I was really doing God's work. I suppose in a sense, it truly is one thing to talk and read God's word. It's quite another to be seen to be living it out. Reading Deuteronomy chapter 10 today, let's open God's word with prayer. Lord, I ask that as I read your word, that you reveal something new to me. I also ask that as people hear your word, they come to better understanding of you. Amen. At that time, Yahweh said to me, cut two stone tablets like the first, and come up to me onto the mountain and make an ark of wood. I will write on the tablets the words that were on the first tablets which you broke, and you shall put them in the ark. So I made an ark of acacia wood, and cut two stone tablets like the first, and went up onto the mountain. Having the two tablets in my hand, he wrote on the tablets, according to the first writing, the Ten Commandments, which Yahweh spoke to you on the mountain out of the middle of the fire in the day of the assembly, and Yahweh gave them to me. I turned and came down from the mountain, and put the tablets in the ark which I had made, and there they are as Yahweh commanded me. The children of Israel travelled from Beeroth, Beni-Jaakan, to Masra. There Aaron died, and there he was buried. And Eleazar his son ministered in the priest's office in his place. From there they travelled to Gudgodah, and from Gudgodah to Jotbathah, a land of brooks of water. At that time Yahweh set apart the tribe of Levi to bear the ark of Yahweh's covenant, to stand before Yahweh to minister to him, and to bless in his name to this day. Therefore, Levi has no portion nor inheritance with his brothers. Yahweh is his inheritance, according as Yahweh your God spoke to him. I stayed on the mountain, as at the first time 40 days and 40 nights, and Yahweh listened to me that time also. Yahweh would not destroy you. Yahweh said to me, arise, take your journey before the people, and they shall go in and possess the land which I swore to their fathers to give to them. Now Israel, what does Yahweh your God require of you, but to fear Yahweh your God, to walk in all his ways, and to love him, and to serve Yahweh your God with all your heart and with all your soul, to keep Yahweh's commandments and laws, which I command you today, for your good. Look, to Yahweh your God belongs heaven, and the heaven of heavens, the earth, with all that is therein. And Yahweh had a delight in your fathers to love them, and he chose their offspring after them, even you, above all peoples, as it is today. Circumcise, therefore, the foreskin of your heart, and be stubborn no longer. For Yahweh your God, he is God of gods, and Lord of lords, the great God, the mighty and the awesome, who doesn't respect persons, nor takes reward. He does execute justice for the fatherless and widow, and loves the foreigner in giving him food and clothing. Therefore love the foreigner, for you were foreigners in the land of Egypt. You shall fear Yahweh your God, you shall serve him, and you shall cling to him, and you shall swear by his name. He is your praise, and he is your God, who has done for you these great and awesome things, which your eyes have seen. Your fathers went down into Egypt with 70 persons, and now Yahweh your God has made you as the stars, the sky, for multitude.